Paul and Neville here, my brother Neville from our local church, and we're going to share some scriptures with you this morning, and I'm going to ask Neville to read me some of the words from 1 John chapter 3 from verse 16. Neville, there you go.
Okay, we know what real love is because Jesus gave up his life for us. So we also ought to give up our lives for our brothers and sisters. If someone has enough money to live well and sees a brother or sister in need but shows no compassion, how can God's love be in that person? Dear children, let us not merely say that we love each other. Let us show the truth by our actions. Our actions will show that we belong to the truth, so we will be confident when we stand before God.
Amen. Amen.
Even if we feel guilty, God is greater than our feelings and he knows everything.
Amen.
Dear friends, if we don't feel guilty, we can come to God with bold confidence, and we will receive from him whatever we ask because we obey him and do the things that please him.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah. And this is his commandment. We must believe in the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, and love one another just as he commanded us.
Yeah.
Those who obey God's commandments remains in fellowship with him and be with him. And we know he lives in us because the Spirit he gave us lives in us. I believe we need to live that sacrificial life which Jesus lived when he gave himself on that cross. And we need to know that and ask him to help us to love one another more, because we can't do it of our own. We need the Holy Spirit to teach us and show us to love one another. And because that was the life of Jesus. He said, I didn't come to be served, but I come to be a servant of all. And so thank you very much.
That's beautiful. That is beautiful. He gave up his life for us so that we also ought to give up our lives for our brothers and sisters.
Yes,
it's a simple transaction. It's a beautiful exchange. I think Wesley said that, a lovely exchange. He gave up his life. He took our sin and he gave us his righteousness.
Yes,
it's lovely. And so when we become Christian, when we follow the Lord Jesus Christ and believe in his name, we have to sacrifice our life and allow Christ to live in us, and we become Christ to the world. Is that your understanding?
Yes, we can't do nothing without Jesus.
That's right.
Because Mary said, whatever he says to you, do it.
Do it. Yeah, amen.
Lord, help us to do the things that Jesus tells us to do, because this brings life, and it also brings the anointing of God upon the things we do, that people can be helped.
Thank you, Neville.
Amen.
And God be with you all. You get into the Word yourself and let the Word of God get into you. See you later.
Yep.
Cheers.
Bye now.